super excited.
Excited?
Actually, over the moon excited with this app that Canva has linked to their software. I'm going to be using my free account to show that the app is available on a free account. And it's going to allow us to bend, warp, twist, and have amazing ideas when we are creating logos or any other creations that you want to create on social media. So open any canvas that you want to use. We're going to be doing a logo for MHN creators and using this very cool tool that we're going to be doing together. Let's go. Because the app has bend, warp, twist, like other cool apps, when on Photopea where you're able to bend and twist and distort and warp, this app allows us to do that with text, but it wants you to have a shape that you're going to warp toward and twist towards. So you're always going to start with a shape that you're going to adjust towards. In our example today, we're going to create a logo that's a circle. So we're going to add a circle. So you could also press your C in order for you to add a circle, and then you have a circle added on your canvas. So let's change the background and make it a nice dark background. Black is always fine, and make the circle bigger.
Make it bigger. Way.
And decide on how big your logo is going to be that you are creating. And you can change the color to whatever color you want. We can make it pink. The next thing that you're going to do is you're going to scroll down to your apps. And when you get to your apps, you're going to search for Typecraft. So you could type Typecraft over there, or you could scroll down. It should show up on your apps. I have not used this account of mine a lot. It's still showing up, but if it's not, you can always type type, and then it's going to give you these two relevant, and you select Typecraft. This is the app's name, and you click on it to open it, and it will show you that this is an app that's going to allow us to bend, warp, twist, and come up with very cool, crazy ideas. Then you're going to select open. Awesome. So let's quickly walk through what you can do with the app. It gives you an option to type the text that you want to create. When you click on the fonts, it gives you various fonts that are gorgeous from Canva that you can use to design your logo, to design whatever text you want to design. And when you click outside, it gives you the three styles that are available. Only three at the moment. We don't know how many we're going to get. We're just excited that we have none. When you click on unfilled, it means your text are not going to have filler inside. Therefore, you only get the border color. And then it looks like that. And if you have none, it looks like that. And you could change the color. If you have outline, that means you have a border as well as the filler inside. Therefore, you're going to have a color of your inner, and then you're also going to get a border color that you can manipulate and change, and it looks like that. And the last section is your edit shape. This is where you bend, twist, and have all sorts of fun. But the last very important thing is the add element to design. We're going to do this together just now, but you will change your design on your left hand side, and then you will adjust it on your right hand side on your canvas itself to add element to changing whatever design that you're going to be doing. So we're going to do this together, don't stress. Next, we're going to be designing MHN. So it's capital letter MHN. And the font, I don't want Anton Italic. I'm going to scroll down and pick a font that I like for this logo. Hopper Hewitt Bold. Let's see how it looks like. Looks like that. Nice and round. I like that. And then I want to leave it as an outline with a filler and a border. And I want to change color to, I love blue, but you know, I can't always design blue logos. Let's go with red this time. So let's go with red. And you can write your own hex code if you have a hex code that you found on Color's website or other websites that you want to use. When you click outside, it's gone, and then your border color, you decide what kind of color you want for your border. So let's make this one a nice black, and then we have those two colors, and then our design looks like this. So you can decide how big your border you want it to have. As you can see at the bottom of the page, it gives you an indication of how big the border is going to be on your logo. And now you get to the design section, or the editing of our text. And this is where we start twisting and tugging and turning. And when you have written a text like we've done, and we have MHN, you can edit the whole text this way.
If you don't like the shape, you can use the reset shape button, and then it resets and you start again. If you're happy,
and then you can click to add to element, and then it adds it to your shape. And this is where you start tagging. Do you see you have an option of update element, meaning you can say, okay, I don't like the way that it fits. So let's quickly do that and try to fit it on our circle like this. And we clearly see that it's not fitting the circle the way that we want. Then we start tagging and twisting and warping the design. So we're going to stretch it a bit. When you start stretching, you can click on update element, and then it updates it on your right hand side. And that's what you would do then. You would tug and twist and turn until you are happy with the design, the way that it fits the shape that you've added. So I'm going to do all of that until I'm happy. And then once it's done, that's pretty much it.
How cool is this? Oh my word, I'm so happy.
Okay, while I tug and turn and do that, I will fast forward, and then we can finish off the design. And we are done with our design. So what you would then do is you're going to go to your position and look for your layers and delete this layer, the shape that was guiding us. We don't need it. And you'd be left with your MHN design. What I would then do, I would go back to my elements and I would look for a circle just to complete the design that I'm creating. And I would look for graphics, and I would look for a nice thin graphic that I can use, like this one. As a last thing that I would do, I would add the tagline for the company, and I would just add the letter spacing and spread it out. Okay, you could play around with how you would like to add your tagline. You could make it circle around the design. It's a designer's choice. And the app is absolutely amazing. We're going to be doing a lot more videos showing how we can manipulate, bend, warp. I love warp. So I'm going to be creating a couple more videos. And you can let me know in the comments below if you're enjoying this and what kind of more videos you'd like us to create with this new tool. You know, we are the logo 3D queens. So we're going to download this as a normal design. We're going to remove the background and then convert it to 3D. So I'm going to fast forward the converting to 3D. If you want to learn how to add your mockups to smart mockups on Canva, go watch this video. Thank you so much for joining me today. I will see you on the next video.